wonder why I do whatever I like. I do what I like, I do, I do, I do what I like, I do, I do. Hey you guys, and welcome back to my channel. So as you guys can see with the title of today's video, your girl's going to be doing a slick back two puff hairstyle. And honestly, I have not worn this hairstyle in a good minute, so it's gonna be really fun for me to transition from this hairstyle to that hairstyle. I'm excited, and I did a poll on my Instagram to see if you guys would want this rather on YouTube or my Instagram, and you guys actually want both. So I'm doing a tutorial not only here on my YouTube channel, but I'm also doing a tutorial on my Instagram as well. And before we get into this video also, I just want to mention that this lighting is going to be so effed up because it's cloudy as F today. So please bear with me with the lighting adjustment and stuff. But yeah, that's pretty much the concept of today's video. Like I said, I'm super excited. So you guys are going to be following me along on this journey for this hair transition. You know what I mean? So before we get into this video, why don't you guys go ahead and follow your girl on all her social medias, which is her Instagram and her Twitter. And then why don't you guys also go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Okay, subscribe to your girl's channel. Why don't you guys also go ahead and hit that notification bell so you guys can be notified every time I upload a new video here onto my channel as well. And yeah, you guys, like I said, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into this video. Hey you guys, so your girl had already pre-detangled the hair off camera and pre-shampooed and conditioned the hair as well. So that's how it transitioned into this beautiful afro puff. Of course, and now we're going to do the second time around with combing the hair. I always like to do that, y'all. I'm so silly. But first, I'm going to go ahead and take my spray bottle, which is with water. And I'm just going to go ahead and add some moisture to my hair because you never want to comb out your hair while it's dry, because you'll take out too much hair than you actually need to. So that's why you want to add moisture in it, so that way it won't take out so much of your hair. And it's a lot more easier to comb too. So I'm just going to take my black wide set comb and I'm just going to go ahead and comb my whole entire head. I don't really have a specific steps on how to do this. I just go all the way around my head from the front to the side to the back to the middle. It's just however I feel. And then once we go ahead and get done with that, we're going to take the super styler comb, and I'm going to take the small set comb on the left side of this, and I'm just going to detangle any small little knots and tangles that I may have in my hair. And then once we get done with that, you guys, I'm going to take my rat tail comb and I'm going to go ahead and create this middle part. Now from the front to the middle, I'm always good at it, but then it was like when it gets to the end, it's like, hey, I try my best, you know what I mean? I try my best to get the middle part as even as possible, you know what I'm saying? Even all the way up to my tiny little baby hairs in the front. So once we got that done, I'm going to go ahead and spray my hair again just to add some more moisture, but I don't spray my whole entire head, just the center part. And of course, I'm going to take some of that soft Softee No Flaking and No Alcohol Hardening Gel, and I'm just going to add that within the inner part of my hair towards the middle part, not throughout the whole entire head. And I'm just going to take my wide set brush with soft bristles and I'm just going to go ahead and brush my hair so we can get it into this puff, this ponytail puff. And then once we go ahead and have that, I just make sure it's wrapped tight, and I always like to pull my hair out just so that way I can have a nice full puff. That's why I don't wet the entire hair completely, that way you're able to have a lot more fuller puff and it looks more like an afro puff. But if you wet the whole entire head, then it ends up being a lot more curlier, and then it kind of shrinks down, so it won't look as full as possible. But you can always take a blow dryer and blow dry it so it can dry faster, and then you'll just have a lot more defined curls, and you can able to pull it out so it can have a more fuller ponytail, but it just won't look like an afro puff like mine's do. You know what I mean? It's whatever you want to do. It's your choice. But this is just how your girl did it for today. And then once I go ahead and get it fully done and put into the ponytail, look at these afro puffs. Look at these two poofs. So cute. Okay, so now we got to go ahead and get started on taking that spray bottle, spraying my hair again. And now we're just going to take some of that Softee, no flaking, no alcohol, hardening gel, and just add some on my edges and add some all the way throughout the ponytails on each side. And now we're going to take a smaller set brush, but with a more harder bristles, and we're just going to go ahead and start laying down these edges, and we're going to go ahead and brush away all these stand up stray hairs that like to stand up throughout the process of me doing this hairstyle. And then I like to go back in with a wide set brush just to really smooth out my hair, because sometimes there's still flyaway hairs even after I do all this brushing. So I just like to take the wide set brush back once again after I use a smaller one, just to kind of smooth everything out. And it's okay if not all the, you know, the stand up hairs are not fully flattened down. It's okay. It's not that big of a deal, but you can also go back with some more gel on top of that as well. And then we're going to go ahead and spray this down once again. And then once we wrap up with this scarf, you will barely see any more of those stand up hairs. So that's why I said it's okay if you do have a few more that were still sticking up no matter what you do, because once you wrap it in a scarf or an old t-shirt, old pair of underwear, no matter what you wrap your hair with, and you let it sit, it's definitely gonna lay all your hairs down. Okay, I usually let my hair sit for about 30 minutes to an hour, and then of course makeup is slayed. Okay, I did a little glam moment, and I'm just gonna go ahead and take the scarf out. Look at that, looks smooth as ever. And now I'm just gonna take some hair clips. I'm just gonna put two on each side. You personally don't have to do this if you don't want to, and you personally don't have to have free edges if you don't want to either. If you would like to slay your edges, you can, but your girl just decided to leave them free and leave them be for this hairstyle, you know what I mean? And then once we add the hair clips in, you guys, of course I had to find something that kind of low-key matched this cute outfit. But that's pretty much it to the hairstyle, you guys, like easy peasy. Hey you guys, and this is the finished look. Now you definitely do not have to add hair clips if you don't want to. You can go freely within your edges, or you can lay your edges. It's all up to you and what you want to do. This is just how I wanted to finish off the hairstyle for today's video. And if you guys like this hairstyle, and if you guys like this hair tutorial, then why don't you guys go ahead and give this video a big old thumbs up, and then comment down below any other makeup look or hairstyle suggestions that you guys would like for me to do here onto my channel. And of course, just in case anyone is wondering what products that I use on my face to get a little glammed up, I definitely will have those products down in the description box down below, along with the products that I use within my hairstyle today as well. And why don't you guys also go ahead and hit the subscribe button, okay? Subscribe to your girl's channel. Do not forget to also hit the notification bell so you guys can be notified every time I upload a new video here on to my channel as well. And do not forget to follow your girl on all of her social medias, which is her Instagram and her Twitter. If you guys are watching me desktop version, then there should be two links up in my banner. And if you guys are watching me mobile, then you can just go to my about section and there should be two links to my social medias there as well. And you guys, like I said, thank you for coming along with me on this journey to this hairstyle, honey, this transformation, darling. Like I said, I'm digging it. I hope you're digging it. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.